Hello students, so I am Manisha Awasthi and I am here with a new topic today in front of you, and the topic is refraction through prism. In the last video, we have seen the refraction formula for the spherical surface. After going through the derivation part, after understanding the formula and the all the terms, we will go ahead with the numerical part. Okay, so this is today we are going to deal the topic is how the refraction occurs in the prism and what formula we are using to calculate the refractive index of the prism, that is mu. See, here I have written one thing, that angle of prism 2A is 120 degree and so angle of the prism is 60 degree. Dear students, you have to do the practical also based on this topic, where you have to calculate that what is an angle of prism. That is a practical part in your 12th class. Now, I am going to take one ray, let us name it as PQ. Or ye PQ jo ray hai, because it is incident on the face AB, face AB par aapki incident hai, that means definitely PQ is termed as incident ray. When the ray of light moves from rarer to denser, we know that it will bend towards the normal. So I am going to have my ray which is bending towards the normal, and this I will again name as QR, and this QR is termed as refracted ray. On the other side, AC, when I will see that AC is again another face of the prism, where I will have what? Ray of light going from denser to rarer, and so it emerges out as RS. So our third ray is called RS, known as emergent ray. So three rays are there: PQ, incident ray; QR, refracted ray; and RS as emergent ray. Again, we know that incident ray or the reflected ray, which makes it the normal, is your angle of incidence and angle of reflection. So I can mark this as this angle as I, and inside the prism I can mark as R1. Now on the other side, this R2, the refracted ray with your normal, is going to be the angle of incidence. Why? Because this side, the ray when hit the space AC, your R2 is an angle of incidence, and you will, the ray RS will make an angle of emergence E. Okay, so this is emergent ray making an angle E. I hope these many angles are clear to you. Let us give a name O here. The point where both the normals are meeting, I have given the name O. In the last video also I have told you that don't change the nomenclature off and on. Whatever ray you are dealing, take it forever till the end, so that the angles, the triangles, you will not get confused. आपको बहुत confusion होगा अगर आप बार बार ray और इसके angle. कई लोग, कई बच्चे PQRS दे सकते हैं, PQR दे सकते हैं. So अगर आपने prism का angle ABC नहीं लिया, PQR ले लीजिए, but वही लेकर के study करिए. Now I can give again the name, let it be the normal drawn, NN and dash. Another new term is going to have in our prism. Actually, what happened? You know very clear that when white light in a prism falls, it gets splitted into seven colors. And that splitting of white light, what do we say? We are saying it as that we are having to able to disperse various ray of light we are getting. So that vibrio which we are getting, depending on the wavelength of the light, is known as dispersion of light. So when white light is incident on the prism, it can get dispersed into seven color. But on the other hand, if suppose it is not dispersed into seven color, agar humko seven colors nahi dikh rahe hai, dispersion nahi ho raha hai, that means ray jo hai apne path se sirf deviate ho rahi hai. Kyun? Kyunki ray ne apna medium badla hai. Rarer se denser aayi hai, denser se fir rarer gayi hai. So I can say that ye jo PQ straight jana chahiye thi, it is not going straight, but it deviate as RS. Wo thode se usne apne path ko deviate kar diya, alag chali gayi hai. To agar wo seedhi jati, to I think ye dotted line aapko very clear hai ki if PQ is going straight, then it must go like this, which I have extended forward with the help of dotted line, and RS I can extend backward. RS को जो emergent beam को है वो मैंने पीछे की तरफ लिया है और PQ को forward लिया है. So they both meet and make an angle known as angle of deviation. This is a new term which you have to study in 12th, that is del angle of deviation. Means when a light is incident on the prism, it suffer refraction and how it get deviate from it path and how much it deviates. That is called del angle of deviation. So our first thing is that what and how we can calculate this del in our prism. Second thing, what is the relationship between I and del? Then what will be the refraction formula mu for the prism? These three, four things will come across in today's topic. Okay? So first we'll start that. What is the relationship between I and del? This, as I have said you, is in your theory as well as in your practical. So there was a relationship, you can prove it experimentally also. On increasing the angle of deviation, what happened? On increasing means what? I can take angle of deviation 30, I can take 35, I can take 40, I can take 45. That means what I am doing? I am just increasing the value of angle of incidence. On the other side, when I will calculate del, that what is the deviation occur, then I will find it out that if suppose for 30 degree I am getting nearing 30 or 29 degree, suppose this is going to be same or approximately same, later on jaise jaise aap angle of incidence badhate jayenge, angle of deviation kam hota jayega. Yani agar humko 30 mila hai to agla angle 28 hoga, usse aur kam hoga yani 26 hoga, and approximately ye niche ki taraf kya hota ja raha hai, kam hota ja raha hai. Balki yahan humne angle of incidence ko kya kiya hai, badhaya hai. So on increasing the angle of incidence, angle of deviation decreases. But ek particular stage ke baad, automatically angle of incidence will increase. That means jaise yahan 26 tha, 28 se 26 kam hua hai. Hum dekhenge deviation kam ho raha hai. Usko hum aise aise compare nahi karenge ki 30 ke liye agar humko 30 mila hai to 35 ke liye humko 28 mil raha hai. Iska matlab 30 se deviation 28 kam hua hai. So if I will find that 26 के बाद deviation बढ़ गया, 28 हो सकता था, 27 हो सकता था, 29, experimentally कुछ भी हो सकता है, तो अगर ये आपका बढ़ा, then definitely the angle above H is going to give you the angle of minimum deviation. जैसे ही वो स्टेज क्रॉस होती है, तो उसका प्रीवियस एंगल आपको लेना पड़ता है, it's an angle of minimum deviation. अर्लियर यही एक एक्सपेरिमेंट हम करते थे इन द डार्क रूम, और डार्क रूम में स्पेक्ट्रम जो होता है, जो हमको सेवन कलर्स का स्पेक्ट्रम दिखता है, वो उल्टा रोटेट होने लगता है इन स्पेक्ट्रोमीटर. तो जहां से वो अपोजिट एंटी क्लॉकवाइज से क्लॉकवाइज हो जाता है, उस पर्टिकुलर स्टेज से हम वहां कैलकुलेट करते थे कि वहां के बाद देयर इज अ पोजीशन ऑफ मिनिमम डेविएशन. पर अभी हमारे पास सिर्फ प्रिज्म है और हमको इसके लिए प्रैक्टिकली आई और डेल का रिलेशनशिप निकालना रहता है. तो एक लाइन हम यहाँ पे मेंशन कर सकते हैं कि ऑन इंक्रीजिंग द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस, एंगल ऑफ डेविएशन डिक्रीजेस, बट अ पर्टिकुलर स्टेज एक सर्टेन वैल्यू के बाद देयर वाज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस, एंगल ऑफ डेविएशन विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, एंड एट दैट पोजिशन प्रिज्म इज सेट टू बी इन द पोजिशन ऑफ मिनिमम डेविएशन. जब हम वो कंडीशन लेंगे तब हम मिनिमम डेविएशन की कंडीशन में डेल की जगह डेल एम लिख सकते हैं, आई के इक्वल हम ई बताएंगे, मतलब एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस और एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस विल बी एक्जेक्टली इक्वल, एंड आर वन इज इक्वल टू आर टू इज इक्वल टू हम आर. ये हमारी कंडीशन रहेगी एट द स्टेज जहां हम मिनिमम डेविएशन पे प्रिज्म की रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स की वैल्यू निकालना चाहेंगे. करेक्ट. अब हम अपने डेरिवेशन पार्ट पे आ जाते हैं. सो हियर आई हैव मार्क्ड, जैसे आप देख सकते हैं, हियर दिस एंगल ऑफ प्रिज्म, लेट अस गिव सम नेम. हियर आई कैन गिव टी. टी कौन सा पॉइंट दिया मैंने, वहां पे दिया है जहां पे आपकी इमर्जेंट रे और इंसिडेंट रे आपस में मिल रही है. लेट इट बी टी के. तो वो रे कहां तक गई है, के तक गई है. आई होप एंगल सारे क्लियर होंगे. अब मैं कुछ एक ऐसा एंगल पे आपको बोलना चाह रही हूँ जहां पे आपको थोड़ा ध्यान देना पड़ेगा. इस नॉर्मल को जो हमने पॉइंट आउट किया, दिस इज द नॉर्मल विच इज मेकिंग एन इंसिडेंट रे, एंड हियर ऑल्सो इट्स अ नॉर्मल विच इट इज मेकिंग विद द इमरजेंट रे. सो इट इज वेरी क्लियर कि ये आई था एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस, ये आर वन था, बट टोटल इट इज 90. और यू कैन से दैट टोटल 90, और आई कैन से कि दीज आर टू वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल. अगर ये वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल है तो अगर ये आपका आई है तो ये पूरा भी हम क्या मेंशन कर सकते हैं, आई मेंशन कर सकते हैं. ओके अगर ये आई है, ये पूरा वर्टिकली अपोजिट आई है, लेकिन उसमें से हमने नीचे वाला एंगल ऑलरेडी मेंशन करा है आर वन, सो द रिमेनिंग लेफ्ट ओवर एंगल इज आई माइनस आर वन. ओके अगेन आई एम सेइंग यू द क्लियर, गिविंग यू द कंसेप्ट. जैसे यहां मैंने कहा एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस ई है, अगर ये एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस ई है तो ये जो दोनों डॉटेड लाइन के बीच में मैं एंगल बताऊंगी, दैट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू बी ई. लेकिन मैंने बिगिनिंग में ही बता दिया है कि रिफ्रैक्टेड रे जो हमारी है वो आर टू बना रही है नॉर्मल के साथ, तो अगर ये ई है, ये ई है, ई में से आर टू चला गया, दैट मीन्स द रिमेनिंग विल बी वॉट, ई माइनस आर टू. This point you have to keep in mind कि normal जहां हमने बनाया है, जहां से हमने दो normals को मिलाया है, वहां पे हम ऊपर R1 नीचे बनाएंगे, तो ऊपर हमारा होगा I minus R1, I will make you little more clear, ये हमारा R1 है, and this dotted line is going to make here its I minus R1, and here I am going to make what its E minus R2. Okay, these two angles are made with the incident, emergent, and with the normals. So I think now the angles are clear to you. I will consider the different triangle and quadrilateral. It's very simple. Now you can say in a triangle QOR. QOR. I hope it is clear to you. Q This is O and this is R. In Q, O, R, one is angle O. So this is angle O because I don't know its value. Plus, another one is R1 means angle R1. Another one is R2 means angle R2. So sum of all the triangle is what? It's 180 degree. So here I can give this equation. The sum of the triangles angle O, angle R1, angle R2 is 180 degree. Okay. Now I will consider quadrilateral. These four points means I am going to consider a quadrilateral A, Q, O, R. This is one complete quadrilateral. In this complete quadrilateral, I already mentioned these two are the points where we have done the normal means 90 degree. So I can say the angle Q is equal to angle R is equal to 90 degree. Okay, because at both the points I have drawn the normal. In the beginning I have told you. So now angle A plus angle O plus 90 plus 90 is equal to 360. Because the sum of the quadrilateral are angle A on this side, angle O on the opposite side. Here 90, so total 180. So 180 can go on the other side, it will 360 minus 180. That means I will get angle A plus angle O is equal to 180. Let it be equation number 2. So first I have got angle O equal to angle O plus R1 plus R2 is 180. Second angle A plus angle O is equal to 180. I can see in both the sides we are having RHS equal to 180. I can equate and I will get R1 plus angle R2 is equal to angle A. Can I get it? How? Because I will compare these two equations. When I will compare it, angle O and angle O will cancel and I will get that angle A, which is angle of prism, is nothing but R1 plus R2. Let it equation number 3. Okay. Now I will consider the triangle which is having the deviation del. So make it very clear. You are going to consider Q, R and T. I hope in diagram it is clear. Q, then R and this is T. So we know that in the triangle when the del is outside, means in a triangle your del is outside of the triangle, then it is equal to sum of opposite interior angle. This is a property, we already know it. That means angle of del is equal to sum of opposite angle, means I minus R1, this is my first angle, plus E minus R2, because these two angles are opposite angle. Can I write del is equal to I plus E minus of R1 plus R2, isn't it? Now just now we have seen R1 plus R2 is nothing but angle A. So I can say del is I plus E minus A, or del plus A is equal to I plus E. Student, this is very important identity formula which is used for calculation of deviation del, where you have given the angle of incidence and emergence, because you can see that angle of A is angle of prism, which is already I have told you it is 60 degree. So angle of deviation, this is as it is also sometimes it comes in exam, ki show that for a prism angle of deviation, sum of angle of deviation and angle of prism is nothing but angle of sum of incidence and the emergence. So till here one part is over. Now as I have told you, we can calculate the refractive index also. So for the refractive index, we are going to apply our condition of minimum deviation. What the Snell's law says? It says mu is equal to sin I by sin R. Sin I by sin R, okay? I and R I have to find out. So what I will use? I will make the use of equation 3 and let it be given number 4. Equation 3, I will apply the condition. What is R1 equal to R2 equal to R? So our equation 3 says R1 plus R2 is equal to A. That means R plus R is 2R is equal to A. That means R is equal to A by 2. And in the fourth identity, when I will keep, I can say del M plus A is nothing but I plus I, because instead of E, I can write I. And here I will get 2I is equal to del M plus A, or I is equal to del M plus A bar 2. These all are very very helpful formula for your numerical. So while doing this topic, you keep in mind the steps and try to by heart in it derivation itself. At last I can substitute the formula of I and R in my refractive index formula. Sin I by sin R means sin A plus del M by 2 whole divided by sin A by 2. And this is our formula for refractive index for the prism and the how refraction occurs, yeah, how deviation occurs in case of the prism. From this topic only, our next topic is going to be related, and that is the deviation for the small angle prism. I hope, student, today's topic is very clear to you. Practice yourself, and if you like my video, then please like and subscribe the video. Thank you so much.